today, when you go for the economic feasibility test, at first you see, I have already discussed along with you the adoption of the higher technology. This is the important one. Adoption of the higher technology necessarily it required the what credit. But one thing is there that I have discussed in the first class, that though we, the higher technology is capital intensive, the farmers are generally are capital starved. And farmers are in the grip of what? Grip of the lower productivity. That is this lower income leads to the lower investment and lower what? Productivity again it goes to the lower income. This vicious cycle of the lower productivity is going on in Indian agriculture. Isn't it? So we have to inject the finance from outer side, from institutional sources to break this lower productivity cycle in the Indian agriculture. So yeah, I'm giving, it is necessary the institutional agencies to provide the needed of a capital through credit. It is through credit which can provide the credit capital to the farmer, isn't it? The farmers need credit. I've already discussed that at the right time, from right agency, that they can go for the using of the credit in a profitable way, and they can go for the increasing in the productivity. And bankers, what the bankers need? Bankers need the what? The when the farmers, after taking loan, they generally look for the viability of the investment. That the farmers may get the higher productivity, it leads to the higher income, is not it? So generally look for the where the farmers will go for, after taking loan, go for investing in the how, in what way. They are looking for this that particular point, is not it? So generally the bankers or the bank will look for the what? The what enterprise the farmers will select after taking loan. This is important. Whether they just propose investment, I'm saying you here the proposed investment. Proposed investment, the farmers after taking loan, where he will go to investing that amount of money in the form of credit, whether that enterprise is profitable or not. The bankers will look for this because the banker have to go for, look for the recovery of the loan of the by the farmer. This is important, isn't it? So, if you see, we have to go through the some guidelines. It is purely management. Guidelines that when the issue is taken up, three basic financial aspects are assessed by the banker. Banker will look for this. Will the project, means the proposed investment, isn't it? Will the project generate additional return to cover additional cost if the loan is advanced? Why I'm giving the additional return and additional cost? These two terms, can you assume? Can you guess it? Additional return and additional cost? Because one thing, the farmer, suppose you look for this. Farmer is in an existing situation, in a cropping pattern, isn't it? And he will go for the taking loan for one reason, that is increase the productivity, isn't it? So increase the productivity only possible through the diversification of the crop. He must shift from his existing pattern to another pattern. So he may withdraw some crop, non-remunerative crop, he may go for the remunerative crop. Likewise, the diversification of the cropping pattern is necessary. And after taking the plan of the diversification of the cropping pattern, he may look for the in what? Investment in the form of the money for higher inputs or other higher technology. It leads to the involvement of the additional cost, isn't it? So it should look for, the banker will look for that particular point. Whether the possibility of the getting additional return sufficiently cover that additional cost or not. Yes, the higher in the adoption of the higher technology may lead for the higher income or return. But we should look for that particular point, or banker will look for that particular point, that whether that additional return sufficiently involvement of the additional cost or not. Then you may call this that or term this that investment is in the good way, in proper way. It should be. Second one. Whether the return, that additional return, has surplus to repay the loan when it is fall due. Only the increasing return is not limited. You should look for that particular point, whether that additional return generates sufficient income to repay the loan, ability to give ability to the farmers to repay the loan when the loan repayment falls due, along with the interest. And third point is the most important point. As you know, that agricultural occupation is vagaries to the nature. We cannot rule out the involvement of the bricks in the agricultural occupation, in the form of flood, in the form of drought, in the form of the pest and diseases. We have to cooperate along with the what? Bricks. So we should look for that enterprise. When the farmers will go for the proper any type of investment, he should, along with the repayment capacity, along with the higher income, he should have the ability to overcome the risks. Then if we get the three positive answers for its three questions, that is, the whether the additional return sufficiently cover the additional cost, second one, whether the farmer will get the sufficient repayment capacity, and third one, when the farmers have the ability to overcome the probability of the financial losses, then we can, you see, the three questions are positive, the loan may be advanced. And if the answer of any of the questions is negative, then the loan proposal you simply call as an unsafe propositions. Do you understand? We look for this particular point. This is important, three important aspects. So why you consider this guideline? This first point is coming from the farmer's point of view. First point. First thing, the fundamental decision importance to the borrower. Farmer being as a borrower, they have to take the decision whether to borrow or not to borrow. Before taking the enterprise or thinking of particular thing, the whether he should think about this, the whether he should go for borrowing or not to borrow. Second point, if he take the decisions to borrow, then he to how to borrow. He have to take how to borrow. Then third one is the from whom to borrow. That is the selection of the proper institutions from whom to take loan. Then fourth one, how best can be borrowed fund be used. That is the utilization, the way of utilization of the loan in profitable way. And then fifth one, this is related to the repayment plan. In selection of the proper repayment plan, it should be best suitable, the repayment selection of the repayment plan suitable according to the repayment capacity of the borrower. There's a selection of the repayment plan. And sixth one, we should look for the risks. What type of, what up to what extent of risks is involved in the particular, taking the particular enterprise, where the farmers will go for the investing the money in the form of borrowed fund or loan. Do you understand? So the borrower has to make national decision on these three, on these six numbers of questions. Okay? Then you come to this. You see, on the basis of this guideline, okay, six already given, a farmer decided to borrow. The extension agency involved, third agencies involved, advocate the loan proposal, and the lending agencies may take to advance the decision to advance the loan. So these three guidelines simply in the managerial economics and financial economics simply may be known as the economic feasibility test of the credit. I have already mentioned to you that economic feasibility tests are popularly known as the 3 R's of credit. First one is the first R coming from the return. First, return. That is the income. Return from the investment. Second one, repayment capacity. Ability of the repay the loan, R, second R. Third one is the risk-bearing ability of the farmer. That is this ability of the farmer to overcome the risks in the form of the probable financial losses due to involvement of the risks. This is 3 R's of credit. Okay? So, you see, first test, return from the investment. This is an important measure to in credit analysis. The important measure for credit. Return is the most important one. First one, we have to look for the return or income. This farmer demand for credit can be accepted only when the additional return, I have already, again I'm quoting here, is more than the additional cost with borrowed fund. That we should look for that particular point always, that a return should be sufficiently cover the additional involvement with the additional cost due to the what investment of the additional money, or you may call as a due to the adoption of the higher technology or through the diversification of the cropping system. Okay? So the problem of determining profitable use of capital is a part of decision making process. It is an entirely decision making process. And how? The first one, you see, the selection of the suitable crop or livestock. Livestock, all the allied activities are available along the farmers, livestock, enterprise, or he may go for a combination of the both. That is this crop along with the livestock. And you should have the ability to take decision which will give the highest return in a particular agroclimatic conditions. Then selection of the enterprise, selection of the in the form of crop, in the form of livestock, or in the combination of the both, and it should be suitable according to the existing agroclimatic conditions that he may go for the increasing his return. And second one, determination of the most economical production technology. This is important for what point? Most economical production technology, if we go for the selection of the most economical production technology, yes, there are lots of the production technology available along with the farmers. Or you may give the guidelines, or you may advocate the farmers probably go for the production technology, different production technology. But one important thing is along with us, that is this, along with the increasing the return or income, we should look for the, okay? Minimization of the cost may go for the, may help the farmers to go in for the increasing his income or productivity. Minimization cost may be possible only through the, if the farmer is in the position to select the most economical production technology. Isn't it? So second point is coming from that particular point. And third one, determination of the appropriate size of the each enterprise depending on the availability of the resources. So the availability of the resources. You know the resources, isn't it? The availability of the resources to the farmer is the important one. And considering the availability of the resources to the farmer should go for the what? Selection of the most appropriate enterprise. He should not go for that particular enterprise that where the resources are generally, other resources are generally coming in the form of scarce. In selection of the enterprise, he should look for that particular point that the resources that are to be required for that particular enterprise, whether it is available to the farmers or not. He should look for that particular point. Okay? If it is available, then he may go for the selection or to the enterprise. Because if resources are available at the right time, at the right or in needy time, then he may go for the investing of the resources in proper way. Otherwise, there may be diversification of the what? Money or diversification of credit, possibility of diversification of the credit, isn't it? So that particular three, these are the three major problems are generally associated with the process of the decision making process in investing of the money in the form of the loan or in the form of credit after taking loan. Okay, it is important. Then yes, the estimation of return of the total production with existing and alternative or proposed farm plan. Then why I'm giving you these two terms here? One is the existing, one is the proposed. Why it is coming? Can you tell me? I have already mentioned to you that one is the existing. You can make a, what? You can give an information by the asking the farmer regarding his existing situation, what type of crop he is going now, what are the crops are involved, what amount of money is involved in the form of working capital or in other way, you make a plan. You have the ability to make a plan, isn't it? Farmer is going, the what type of crop he is growing now, okay? What amount of cost is involved? And considering all these things, you may go for the estimation of the return. This is called existing plan. This is already going on plan, isn't it? This is existing plan, okay? Then considering his existing plan or existing cropping pattern, I'm not even existing cropping pattern, after taking loan, you may give the guidelines or you may advise the farmers to go for the diversification of the existing plan. That you can introduce new crops to the farmers, you can give the advice to the farmer, introduce new crop, you should go for this type of a hybrid variety, you may go for introduction of a new crop, you try to eliminate the non-numerative crops, you can give the guidelines, isn't that it? And then you can give advice to the farmers to what? Investing in the what? Investing of his money, both in the equity, net capital, his own savings, or along with the borrowed fund. Then you can make a feasible, what? Plan. This is maybe called as a, what? Proposed plan. One is the existing, as is already existed along the farmer, then you may go for the making of the proposed plan. Okay? So two plans is coming here, two budgets. In the existing plan, you can also give the farmers, that help the farmers to an estimation of his return. Then in proposed plan, you can give also, what? Estimation of the return. So two budgets are coming here. So I am giving the first point. One is the existing plan, second one is the alternative or proposed plan or alternative farm plan. Okay? Second point, estimation of prices expected to prevail during the relevant period. Why I'm giving here the estimation of the prices that are to be when we come, how we can calculate the gross return then? First simply you can tell me. Can you tell me the how we can go for the estimation of the gross return? Gross return can be estimated only through simple. Only through? Oh, yes. Amount of production multiplied by prices. This is the simple gross return, isn't it? So, what happened? Our aim in the proposed plan to go for what? To go for the estimation of the higher? Go for the return? That is this. It should be a higher return. So, we should look for that particular point. For on the sake of the giving the showing of the higher return, we should go for what? Considering the prices that are prevail in during the period. We should not go for the abrupt prices. For the sake of the going the showing of the higher return, we should not go for that particular prices that were not prevail in the that particular situation. We should go for that considering the price. You may consider the what? Prevalent market price, procurement price, minimum support price. These are that some terminology we can maybe used for estimation of the what? Gross return. We should not look for that particular, we should look for that particular point that in estimation of the gross return, we should not consider the higher level of prices, only to check the showing of the higher gross return. You should be careful. And third one, use of average yield for crops or enterprise to estimate the expected production of each enterprise. This is also to show the higher gross return, we should not look for the, we should not show the yield, which is not possible in that particular situation. We should look for the, at least the potential yield, that to be maybe prevail in that particular situation. Dekhawa lage buliye tumi ekhupa dekhwani diba. Suppose the particular crop, you will get the per hectare 15 quintal. We should not look for that on that way that I will give you the possibility of getting return. Instead of 15 quintal, you may give the 25 or 30 quintals. But it is not possible. So you should look for that particular point. Okay? So yield, along with the price, we should look for the yield. It should be average yield. Okay? And then estimation, then you may go for the estimation of the gross return. So considering the feasible price, considering the feasible production, we may go for estimation of the gross return in the proposed plan. Then determination of the actual working expenses, which should be always the marginally higher than the actual. Yes, it is important, the working capital. One thing I'm telling you here, I'm not mentioning here, that is this one for the banking organizations, one thing. There's a lots of cost concepts that are involved. We have gone through it. We may go for the gross return. We may go for the estimation of the cost A, cost B, cost C. Then family, we may estimate the family level income, then first business income, then we may go for the estimation of the net income. Isn't it? But one important thing is that in Indian conditions, there may be possibility of the getting of the negative return or negative return when we consider all these type of cost concepts. Because when we consider the cost A, cost B, like all this, you will get in the higher classes. All this, we have to consider several things. We have to consider the imputed value of the family labor. We have to consider imputed value of own bullock labor, home produces. All these things are generally considered in going for in calculation of this type of cost concepts. Okay, but banking organizations are generally looking for the one particular point, that is this return in the form of profit. Return in the form of profit. And profit is estimated only through the considering only on the particular point, that is this, what amount of working capital involved in his particular enterprise. And working capital is considered on the basis of the one term that is called banking organizations are looked for the particular point that is called scale of finance. That is actual cash expense that are to be incurred by the farmer. Actual cash. Do you understand? Actual cash expense that are to be incurred by the farmer from his pocket in his enterprise, as generally considered as here the working capital. That is cash expense arrived on the particular points, that is what purchasing of the basic inputs, fertilizer, seeds, etc., etc. Payment of wages to the whom? Labor. Payment of wages to the hired labor, that means I am telling you. The payment of wages to the hired bullock labor, isn't it? These are the payments that are to be considered for the hiring machinery, power tiller, pump sets. These are the some items where the cost involved, cash involvement are generally considered. And all these are considered here the working capital of the that are to be involved in the enterprise by the farmer. And when we consider this working capital, that is the scale of finance, that is the cash expenses, then we may go for the estimation of the what? Actual income or profit. And these type of costs are generally considered by the banking organization in estimation of the actual return or probability of getting return by the farmer. Instead of going for all these type of cost, then estimation of the net income by deducting the estimated cash expenses that I am giving you. Estimated cash expenses from the gross income. That is this cash expenses in the form of the what? Working capital. In the estimation of the net return, according to the ICR norms, we have to go through the different cost concept. First point. Okay? We have to calculate cost A, cost B, different cost. Then we may go for the estimation of family labor income. This is another estimation. Then farm business income. Then we may go for the estimation of the net income. Do you understand? And there is the one problem along with this cost. That is, we have to consider all, when we consider all these costs, we have to consider several items. We have to consider imputed value. Imputed value, do you understand? Imputed value of the family labor. Not only the higher value, we should consider the family labor cost also. Own bullock labor cost also. Home produces cost also. All these things are will consider. Okay? Then we may go for the estimation of the net income after covering all these different types of income. Then we may go for the estimation of net income. I am saying you here, in Indian conditions, there is the possibility when we consider all this type of cost, this is one possibility of the getting of the net return, considering the socio-economic conditions of the farmer. I am saying of the underemployment, problem of the underemployment in Indian agriculture, is not it? So due to this problem, there's a what? High amount of the family labor are engaged in the per unit of area. Lage duta. When we consider all this type of there's a possibility of getting a negative return or net return. But what happened? This is not possible for the farmer going for the any taking of any formal loan by against enterprise. Any type of showing any type of enterprise. So the banking organizations now instead of going for all this type of costs, generally they go for the one thing. That is this call generally for the banking organization, that is they are try to operate, this is called scale of finance. Their interest along at the particular point, that is the working capital, that is in the form of cash, mind it, in the form of cash, how much money he is incurred from his own pocket in the form of working capital. They are considered only the cash involvement in the enterprise. Do you understand? Then, because they are interested only the profit. And when this working capital in the form of cash incurred by the farmer, then banking organization may go for the estimation of the viability of the project instead of going for all this type of cost. So, in estimation of the net return, in the return, we generally deduct gross return minus the what? Actual cash expense incurred by the farmer from gross income. You'll get it clear in the practical. Okay? Then, again I am saying, accordingly two budgets we have to prepare. You'll get it in practical. Two budgets. One budget is the existing resources only. And another alternative budget, budgets with existing resources plus what? Loan required for the proposed investment. Now, we have to prepare two budgets. One existing plan, another one is the, what will you say? Alternative farm plan or proposed plan. One budget is the proposed budget or alternative budget, one is the existing budget. Then the net income differences in two budgets will give the estimate of the what? Additional cost and return. The difference between the two budgets will give you the additional cost and return. When it will be cleared by you, when we quantify it, all these two budgets in the practical class, okay, along with the data. Okay? So, second one, first return is over. After estimation return, we should look for the estimation of the repayment capacity. It is the second test of economic feasibility or credit management. And it can be defined as the ability of the farmer to repay the loan when it falls due within the stipulated period along with the cost of fund, that is rate of interest. Do you understand? Loan may be productive to generate additional income, but sometimes it may be not productive enough to repay the loan along with the interest. Loan, yes, loan always may be considered if it is going for the investment in a particular enterprise, may be productive. But we should look for a particular point that it should be productive to that extent that it has given the ability to the farmer to repay the loan and with due additional cost, that is interest, in a due time. And we have to estimate the repayment capacity. Hence, necessary condition of loan approval, loan should be not only the profitable, but also have the potential for affecting his repayment capacity. Okay? The repayment capacity is generally related to some of the variables we have generally considered. Repayment not only depend on the return, but also several other factors. Several other factors, this is working expenses, working capital. If working capital high, cost involvement is the high. So, negatively related. Then family consumption high, it is negatively related. Other loans due, negatively related. Then literacy, positively related. Then managerial scale of the farmer, positively related. Then the social status is positively related. So these are the relationship of the other variables along with the repayment capacity. So we should try to enhance the positively related variables. That is the managerial skill, social status, literacy, all these should be in a higher way. Thus, general estimation of the repayment capacity, I'm giving here gross income. So this is important one. Living expenses is important. We have to consider the consumption cost. Living expenses, mane buji paisa na? Consumption cost, okay? Plus, working expenses, plus taxes and other loans due. If all are considered and deducted from the gross income, we may go for the estimation of the repayment capacity. But one thing, estimation of the repayment capacity is deferred for two types of loans. One is the estimation of repayment capacity for self-liquidating loan is somehow different from the non-liquidating and partially liquidating loan. Then why? So you see, self-liquidating loan. You know the self-liquidating loan? What is the example of the self-liquidating loan I have given in the last class? Most appropriate example, can you give me? Huh? Crop loan. It's a self-liquidating loan. Because crop loan is given by the banking organizations to the farmer to what? To meet the what? To meet the requirement of the different inputs. And after taking loan, the farmers may go for the what? Incurred of this loan or money in the purchasing of the different types of basic inputs. Suppose some amount of money is taken by the farmers, isn't it? After taking loan in the form of crop loan, farmers are going to purchase what? Different types of inputs or payment of different types of required wages to the higher human labor, higher bullock labor, higher machine, etc., etc. So, entire loan amount is converted to working capital, variable capital. So as we are considered as the working capital in estimation of repayment capacity, so as the loan amount is already converted to the working capital, it is no need to consider the loan amount separately for estimation of the repayment capacity, because the amount is already involved in there as a form of working capital. But for non-liquidating and partially liquidating loan, suppose you are going to purchase a power tiller, after taking money, purchase a power tiller or tractor. So what happened then there? This loan is term, called as a term loan. Isn't it? You have to repay the loan in the form of installment in other way according to the repayment plan we should consider for estimation of the repayment capacity for non-liquidating and partially liquidating loan. You have to repay loan in the installment, isn't it? So that amount should be considered in estimation of the repayment capacity. Do you understand? So this is the difference between the estimation of liquidating loan and partially liquidating and non-liquidating loan. This is the only difference. You will get it. So what are the major causes of the poor repayment capacity? We have to consider these causes because we have to enhance the repayment capacity of the borrower. We may help the farmers to increase the repayment capacity of the borrower. So to help the farmers to increase the repayment capacity of the borrower, we have to identify the major problems of the poor repayment capacity. So this is the small size of land holding. This is the another problem. It is the common or major problem in Indian conditions. That is this small size of land holding. That is primary, or we may call it the small size is coming only because of the problem in Indian agriculture, that is the fragmentation of the land holding. And due to this problem, generally we cannot go for the proper, what? Proper adoption of the higher technology in small holding. This is the major problem. And this issue leads to for the poor repayment capacity of the borrower. Next one, the lower productivity and production. This is simple. Lower productivity is a major problem in Indian agriculture. Then low prices, the fluctuation of prices for agricultural commodities. This is related to the marketing. The fluctuation of the agricultural prices of the agricultural commodities is common. It may be rise, it may be decline, isn't it? And it will adversely affect the repayment capacity of the borrower. That is due to the fluctuation of the prices of the agricultural commodities. High family expenditure leads to the poor repayment capacity. Then use of the farm credit in unproductive purposes. That is this diversification of the credit may lead to the poor repayment capacity. That I already mentioned. Then low farmer's equity. This is the another instrument to go for the overcoming of the risks. If the crop is totally failed due to the different types of risks involvement in the agricultural sector, the farmers may go for the overcoming the risk from his own equity or from his own savings. And generally it is not seen in the Indian farmers. And due to which the farmers have to fall in the form of what? The problem of the lower repayment capacity. Then lack of adoption of the improved technology. This is a common one. Okay? And poor management of the farm resources. That is, this combination of the resources in a proper or profitable way is the major problem in Indian agriculture. Okay? Then how we can go for increasing the repayment capacity? We are given. Increasing the net income by proper organization and operation of the farm business. Through proper organization and operation of farm business, we may go for increasing the repayment capacity. Adoption of the potential technology through increasing the production. The removal of the imbalances of the farm resources availability. That given the problem, we have to what? Remove the imbalances in the resource availability. বুঝি পালা আজি বোলে সাৰ আছে হেৰি নাই এইটো হ'ব নালাগে আজি গুটি পাইছা সাৰ নাই আজি বোলে ইনফ্ৰাষ্ট্ৰাকচাৰ ইৰিগেশ্যন লাগে ন' ইৰিগেশ্যন ফেচিলিটিজ ডেট শ্বুড নট বি দেয়াৰ অ'কে চ' শ্বিডুলিং অফ দ্য লোন ৰিপেমেণ্ট প্লেন একৰ্ডিং টু দ্য ইনকাম ফ্ল' ডিফাৰেণ্ট টাইপছ অফ ৰিপেমেণ্ট প্লেন এভেলেবল উইথ দ্য বেংকিং অৰ্গেনাইজেশ্যন এণ্ড আফটাৰ টেকিং লোন দ্য বেংকাৰ্ছ অজ এজ ৱেল এজ দ্য বিং এজ এ এগ্ৰিকালচাৰিষ্ট ইউ শ্বুড গিভ দ্য গাইডলাইন্স টু selection of the proper repayment plan which is suitable to the farmers according to the situation or according to the income he may go for a repay the loan. Okay? Well, that repayment plan which is not suitable to the farmers should be advocated. এটা রিপেমেন্ট প্লেন দিলে যিটো ফার্মাৰক বেডলি এফেক্ট কৰিব পাৰে সেইটো রিপেমেন্ট প্লেন উই শুড নট বি এডভোকেট টু দ্য ফার্মার এডভোকেট টু দ্য ফার্মার দেন ইনক্রিজ দ্য ইকুইটি অর নেটওয়ার্ক দ্যাট ইজ দিস উই হ্যাভ টু লুক ফর দ্য ইনক্রিজিং দ্য ওয়াট ইকুইটি অর নেটওয়ার্ক ওন সেভিংস ইয়াস দেন ডাইভার্সিফিকেশন অফ দ্য ক্রপ এন্টারপ্রাইজ দ্যাট ইজ দিস মোস্ট ইম্পর্টেন্ট ওয়ান উই শুড লুক ফর দ্য পার্টিকুলার প্লেন দ্যাট দ্য diversification of the crop in a proper way is the most important and it will help the farmers to be increasing his productivity or income eta cropote lagi thaki ba heri koi thaki lab nai tumi enako type of guideline farmers you have to give the guidelines to the farmers that he may go for suppose he may remove one crop eta area etu crop koise heta he tumi give the guidelines to the farmer okay that is possible through the diversification of the crop isn't it and improvement of the managerial skill of the borrower that is the managerial skill of the borrower should be there paisa to ani pela cross coin boli bhabi thake lob kot korim keneke korim bujhi paisa ketia korim ei bostu tu at least farmer jono hatot thakibo lagibo proper marketing of the farm products to get the remunerative prices yes this is the problem again I am telling you here the farmers indian conditions is farmers facing the problem of the forced sale or distressed sale due to the proper marketing structure or marketing facilities they have to go for what they have to face the problem of the market surplus or marketing surplus is not it that is one thing is there that farmers to meet the demand in the form of cash after just after harvest to meet the cash demand of the farmer generally farmers have to go for the forced sale or distressed sale and generally they get the non-remunerative prices for due to the forced sale or distressed sale but if the farmers go through the proper marketing organization or through the proper marketing facilities then the farmers will get the remunerative price or actual price he will receive from his own products then if the any marketing organization help the farmers to sell their produce at a right time when the price is high at a right place then necessarily farmers will get the remunerative price from their product and in this case the marketing organizations may help the farmers to go to get the remunerative price from their products and it will help the his repayment increasing his repayment capacity then proper marketing of farm products to get oh yes last one adoption of the risk management strategies like crop insurance the risks I will discuss now and along with this the when the risks is involved we may go for our taking out the one instrument that is this crop insurance is now a new concept along with the banking organizations along with the beneficiary to the farmers if they go for the taking of the facilities of the crop insurance necessarily it will give the boosting of the farmers to overcome the risks that is this new concept crop insurance okay the last one the risk bearing ability it is the ability of the farmer to overcome the probable financial losses due to the involvement of the risks do you understand it is the ability of the farmer to overcome the probable financial losses due to the risks in this sector risks in the form of flood risks in the form of drought risks in the form of pest and diseases etc price fluctuation all these things are considered as a risks and it is also called as a last line of defense in the credit management yes I am giving you here the theoretical concept of the credit management today I will give you the detail of the credit management as a economic feasibility test commonly known as 3R credit in the practical detail assessment of risk bearing ability necessary because return and repayment capacity may hold true on the basis of the average production you will get the return on the basis of average production you get the estimate the repayment capacity but one thing how we can go for the overcoming the risks this is the another important thing coming here you may go for the return you may go for the estimation repayment capacity but one important thing is coming here that is the risks how the farmer will overcome the risks then this full possibility we cannot rule out the involvement of risks in Indian agriculture you know so this results variations in income in the form of returns as a rule so variations in the income due to the risks variations in the income mind it that is the variations in the productivity come as a rule in Indian agriculture. We cannot rule out. So it is important one, risk management. Okay? So how we can go for the estimation of risks? Yes. The remedy. I'm telling you the remedy. That is the estimation of risks can be. Repayment capacity may be deflated according to the probable variations in the gross income in order to arrive at a fairly stable and reliable repayment capacity. Deflated. Then this repayment capacity based on the deflated gross return is simply may be equated to the risk bearing ability of the farmer. Deflated gross return along with the risk coefficient. I'll tell you what is risk coefficient. Repayment capacity under risk, deflated gross return. So instead of, yes, same thing, estimation is the same. Repayment capacity is estimated, we have considered here gross return minus working expenses, excluding the proposed loan, plus family expenses, other loans due, miscellaneous expenses, plus crop loan. Here instead I'm telling, is writing here, what? What is the difference? Deflated gross return. And how we can come for this? Deflated return, how we can be estimated? Risk can be quantified through statistical technique. Yes, it is possible for estimation of the risk for a particular farmer in a particular situation through different mathematical model or in other mathematical tools or etc., statistical tools. It may be in the form of coefficient of variations. It may be in the form of the considering standard deviation, programming models, higher models. Through computer, we may go for estimation of the risks, considering the different types of variables in a one production system or any economic situation. Different types of variables we consider, then we go for the modeling it, and then we go for the estimation of the risks. One thing. Tumaloke iyale swatke agote moi bujhai disu swa. But it is not possible, huna, not possible for the banking organizations to estimate the risks for every farmer considering all this type of functional model or all these things. So generally what happened? The banking organizations take a simple way. You see, there mulaswa, there the possibility of the variations in the what? Yield. One yield is the potential yield. Potential yield of a particular area, how we can define? A two area per hectare possibility for this crop is per ton. This is potential yield. Ekhini ami paun. Okay? Then the actual yield. Actual yield is the may be varied. It may be lower. Only because of what? Due to the different variations in the different variables. That is this in the form of risk. Pabo lagisil iman, payasu iman. This is the gap. Potential yield and the actual yield. Simply considered by the banking organizations in the recent past trend for last or 8 or 10 year time series data. Second, buji paisana? Do you understand? Aji 10 bochor A2 area banker organization hatot thake. That is along with the banking organizations. The A2 corpo karne potential yield iman kintu farmer je pay ase iman due to the risks. And this difference simply may be expressed by banking organization or in any expert in the form of percentage. Do you understand? And this is simply considered as a risk coefficient. That is, I am telling you here, suppose risk coefficient of this area, suppose if I am asking you risk coefficient of this area is 7%. Risk coefficient is 7%, 8%, or it is depends on the situation. It may be from coming from lower part to the higher part. Suppose I am telling you here risk coefficient of this area of Jorhat district is 4%. Necessarily the risk coefficient in the platform district Lakhimpur will be higher, 11% or 12%. That means the possibility of the losing of the productivity is 7% here or 4%. Like this due to the risk. Get it? Yes. Then this risk coefficient simply may be deflated along with the what? Along with the gross return. And when we consider this deflated gross return in estimation of the repayment capacity, when we consider deflated gross return, that estimate simply may be equated to the risk bearing ability of the farmer. That deflated gross return, which is equated to the risk bearing ability, means that we have to compare that deflated gross return along with the amount of loan to be repaid by the farmer on that particular time. Then, if it is coming positive, simply we call as a, so I am speaking here, call as a farmer has a good risk-bearing ability. That means the farmer has the ability to overcome the risks because the repayment capacity already deflated along with the risk coefficient. To me, risk to already humai delay. Deal apply, you are going for the estimation of the return. Okay? And that deflated return simply compared along with the amount of loan to be repaid by the farmer and that particular time or year or month. Then you may call it as a farmer's the good risk-bearing ability. So some of the sources of risk farming is the production risk. Second one is the price risk, fluctuation of the prices. Institutional risk is coming from the banking organizations. Then technological risk is due to the lack of the proper knowledge in the adoption of the proper technology. This coming under technological risk. Then weather uncertainty, it is the risk. Then risk caused by illiteracy, ignorance of the farmer, and the personal risk, that is the inefficiency by sickness. All these things are considered as a, some of the sources of the risk in farming system of our country. Then last one, steps to increase the risk bearing ability. I'm giving here on theoretical basis, development of the owner's equity. It is coming at the first point. That is the farmer's own saving is the main instrument to go for overcoming the risks. Then development of moral character like honesty, responsibility and dependability. Taking up less risky and more stable, selection of the enterprise. That I'm speaking the first point. Then we should go for the what? Selection of the enterprise which is less risky. Isn't it? Then diversification of the crop or flexibility in the production program. Diversification is the adoption of the crop and other insurance scheme. This is the another instrument which help the farmers to overcome the risks. Then reduction of the farm and family expenditure. And adoption of improved technology to minimize the production risks. And making forward contract, this is coming from the marketing side. This we have a forward contract in the marketing that it will help for, it will help the farmers to reduction in the price risks. Forward contract in the marketing system. That if the farmers go for the forward contract, you'll get in the marketing sector. What is the forward contract? Forward contract in the marketing system, then necessarily farmers have the help the farmers to get the remunerative price or actual price from his products. It helps the farmers to minimization of the price risks. And these are the some steps we have generally considered in the what? Increasing the risk bearing ability of the farmer. So you should know for examination point of view or from academically some of the points which can help the farmers the repayment capacity as well as the points that are to be required for increasing the risk bearing ability of the farmer.